Starfall.
Science isn't about why, it's about why not.
Hey guys, welcome back to Starfall Sabers. My name is Nick, and I have a really special reveal to do today. This is a long overdue commission. This was for my older brother. Both he and I are huge Portal fans, and so he came to me and commissioned me to do a Portal themed saber, and so I have that to show off today.
Is anyone there?
Fire. All right, guys, so this video will be basically the reveal of this Portal inspired lightsaber. And what I wanted to do with this originally, when my brother came to me with this idea, instead of just doing a lightsaber that was based on Portal or like a Portal themed lightsaber, I really wanted to try to create or design something that looked like it came from the Portal universe. So essentially, I had a backstory created in my mind that maybe two employees of Aperture Laboratories, two scientists, on their downtime, they had a side project that they were working on. They were Star Wars fans. And since, lightsaber technology doesn't really exist, they set out to make what they felt would be a lightsaber. So using the Portal technology. So there's in the lab, there is this huge energy source that creates a plasma beam that is very stable, but it's a huge machine that has to do it at a huge energy source. So what they did is they used the Portal gun technology and put that right in the housing here. And so basically, when you turn this device on right at the emitter, it's using Portal technology to take that huge energy beam with its huge power system in the laboratory and basically instantly project it right from the emitter of this device. And so that's kind of my super nerdy headcanon for this, but I also wanted it to look similar to the Portal gun itself from the game renders. And so if you're familiar with that, the Portal gun itself is pretty big. It has similar stylings to this. I just wanted to kind of condense it down so that it looked like something that you could, hold in your hand feasibly and believably as a lightsaber. And so in order to do this, some of this was beyond my skill set. So I sketched it out, the design, but this, all the white area, this is all hand sculpted resin. So there's a super talented artist from the UK named Tone Hitchcock, and he does my crate dragon teeth. He's super talented. He works in the movie industry. He works for museums. And so I asked him if he could take this project on. And we ended up trading. I built his sons a couple lightsabers so that he could do this for me. So essentially, this is a hand-sculpted resin cast painted. He was able to get this decal on here as well. Once I got it back, I clear-coated it multiple times with an acrylic semi-gloss. So once he made the mold, the silicone mold, he poured the resin, painted it. And what I did is this is using a Qui-Gon emitter that's modified, and I machined the inner core, because if you look at the actual portal gun itself from the game, it actually has a lot of these same dimensions in this area. So I sent him the piece, and then he form fitted everything around it to ensure that it could sleeve on and attach with these two set screw greeblies here. I added the box, crafted the plate here for the tactile buttons. Didn't want to have this to have to come off or recharge, so I ended up doing an external recharge port here, which I have a kill key for. Nathan Barnes did the install on this. This is running Profi. And Kit Bash Customs, Tyler Sadoff, he created a custom Portal sound font based on the video game for this. It also has these nylon cables here that connect, which are very similar to the in-game model. Simplified, of course, for the lightsaber variant of it. You got the Aperture Laboratories or Aperture Science logos on here as well. And then this was a claw from a Saber Forge hilt that I had some extra parts laying around. And I, rather than doing like the four claws that are on the actual portal gun, just to simplify it, I did the one. And so I think it turned out really cool. This is, it's not something that I would recommend dueling with at all. It's more of just like a high-end collectible piece that's going to sit on the shelf. I mean, you can lightly swing it around, but it's really not meant to be handled all that much. Again, and my brother knew that going in. But it, I'm really happy with the way this turned out. So yeah. So we'll go ahead and fire it up here. I've got the font is going to cycle into the portal font here so you can hear the boot up sound.
Cake will be served immediately.
And then your power button here.
Is anyone there?
And so in the game, there is a little window on the portal device. And so you can see that here.
Target acquired.
We got some sounds from the game. And then, of course, on this portal font, it only cycles between two colors, which is the blue and the orange. Cycle through, you tap and, or hold auxiliary, tap power. And then you got the orange color as well. And push and hold to power down. So we'll put a blade in. You got a 1032 set screw here. And so you back that out, you'll see the blade plug pop out. And we'll get a blade in here. So just kind of apply some pressure to make contact with the pins and then tighten this up here. Looks so cool. Power.
Is anyone there?
There's a bunch of Easter eggs on this font. I need to play with it a little more to access them, but I this video is so overdue. I wanted to get this done. And again, we'll switch back to blue. And push and hold to power down. So that is just the basic function of this long overdue portal gun saber commission. This turned out really cool. Thanks to all the artists who helped out with this, Tone Hitchcock, Nathan Barnes. And this is your kill key here. We're gonna install this. Thank you to Valve for putting out one of the awesomest games ever. I need to go back and play it actually because it is just so hilarious and so fun. So, thanks for watching this reveal, guys. We really appreciate it. I've got a ton more coming down as I fulfill Etsy orders and commissions. So, as always, feel free to follow me on Instagram @starfall_sabers, and we'll see you next time.